Rogers TV, the voice of college football, coming your way, talking Miami football. We bring in Alonzo Oliver, so you can catch him on Alonzo1219 here on YouTube, the U family. Alonzo, how you doing tonight?
I'm doing pretty good. How you doing, Mark?
I'm doing great. I appreciate you jumping on board to definitely set us up for spring practice. I know lots going on after National Signing Day. You pretty happy with that class?
Yeah, you had a few guys jump off ship. I'm not a big fan of talking about who left and everything. You had a few guys jump, but for the most part, got to be pretty happy with the guys that we got. So I'm happy with that, and more happy about seeing the guys that were there last year, how they're gonna grow and progress and see how things go with those guys in spring.
So, Alonzo, we see it every year with these coaching staffs across America, guys jumping ship, going other places. Obviously, the head coaching changes have a lot to do with that. But even when the head coach is still in play and stays, that we see these coaching turnovers like no other profession, I don't think. And Craig Kuligowski, your defensive line coach, much respected, did an outstanding job by all accounts. Everybody liked him. Everybody wanted him to stay, but he jumps to Alabama. And now you got a void there, and you also have some defensive line shakeup.
With Coach Kuhl, you have a lot of people upset with it. I'm looking at it like, I mean, hopefully we can get a young guy. I have no idea who we're going to get in. It's still right now they're saying hopefully they have somebody in by spring. I'm looking at it like he wanted to go play for his former coach that he played for, I'm guessing, in college or something like that. I think Nick Saban was on his coaching staff in college. I think he played under for 1 year. And he went on to a team that's won 5 national championships since Nick Saban's been there, I think. You know, so he wasn't a great recruiter. At Missouri, he wasn't great. Even at Miami, he wasn't a great recruiter. But he knew how to take undeveloped talent and tap into him very well. One of the best defensive line coaches in the country. It's definitely an A-plus hire for Alabama. It definitely hurt Miami scheme-wise, but I believe that most of the scheme that we do use is from Coach Manny Diaz. So I think they'll get another aggressive defensive line coach that can hopefully emulate what Coach Kuhl did, because he understands how to coach technique and how to build guys up. It's a big loss in a teaching standpoint, because of the way he teaches those guys, but hopefully we can. It won't hurt us in recruiting at all. I really don't believe it hurt us in recruiting at all. He's going to a school that he doesn't need to recruit well. You know, they get the best of the best, so all he got to do is continue to let his talent show as a coach, and he may be trying to go for a head coach position somewhere eventually. So that's probably why he made the move. It wasn't a salary move, I don't think, because I believe the defensive line coach that was at Alabama was making less than Coach Kuhl was making at Miami. So I don't think it was a salary jump. I just think it was a jump to where he can get with Saban and probably either become a defensive coordinator somewhere or maybe a head coach somewhere.
So it's a position that would be highly sought after. Defensive line coach, one of the best programs in the country. But I don't necessarily know that the timing is going to work out. Obviously, they're going to get somebody to coach the defensive line. But most of these coaches change jobs that weekend right after the regular season ends, or maybe depending on what happens after bowl play and postseason play, all that coaching shakeup happens then. And then the couple weeks right after that is when all these coaches change jobs, and we're already a month to 6 weeks after that. So they might have some trouble finding at least the guy that they would like to target versus what they would have had, you know, a month to 6 weeks ago. The timing's just a little bit late, but I'm sure they'll find somebody.
I don't know. It's going to have to be somebody young. Like you said, most of the coaches, even speed coaches that we got, guys we're bringing up now, I don't want to bring their names up now anyway, because, you know, they're not, like you said, not going to jump. They're going to have to get a young guy, you know what I'm saying, that's going to have to just get in there and prove himself. And it's happened before, you know, so as long as you have the talent, you just need the coaching. And I believe that with the defensive staff that we have, you know, you can bring in a young guy or somebody who's hungry to teach these young defensive linemen on how to play football. So I have all the faith in Manny Diaz and his defensive staff and Mark Richt on evaluating who they want to bring in as coach defensive line. You have any idea? I have zero idea. I don't think no one has an idea who they're going to bring on. But I do feel like they all evaluated and bringing the bring the right person in. Got to have a culture as well, though. You have to have a culture at Miami as well. So
I've Googled it, and I can't find any names. Apparently, the North Carolina State coach was at defensive line was under consideration, and he stayed put. So that's the only name that I can find. So it's kind of a mystery guy in terms of who they possibly a group of coaches they could be targeting. So we will find out very soon.
That's who everybody wanted. He's a former UM guy, former defensive lineman. That's what everybody wanted. But I kind of knew I kind of knew it was gonna be hard to get him. You know, he's at home at NC State. You know, he's been there for a while, so it's kind of hard to, especially like you say, the time period, the timing. You know, these coaches got to get up and they got to uproot their whole families as well. So you know, it's short timing. Probably not gonna make much. The defensive line coaches, all those position coaches, their salaries are pretty much, if you're in the ACC, SEC, Big 10, Big 12, Pac 10, whatever, your salaries are gonna be kind of on the same structure because you're a position coach, not a coordinator. So you're not gonna make a lot more money. And even if Coach Cool is not, even if he's making the same amount of money in Alabama as he's making in Miami, he's actually making more money because of the cost of living. And you know, it's a lot more money he'll be making because of the cost of living. And people won't understand that as well, but it's totally cheaper to stay in Tuscaloosa, Alabama, than to stay in Miami or Coral Gables anywhere in that area. So